Friends, welcome back. So, today, I thought I'd show you some progress on the paintings that I started last time. I have had a couple of weeks to get going on them, so I've got some good progress for you guys to see, and I thought that would be fun for you guys to just kind of check out a little bit of what I really mean when I say that I work it on multiple pieces at the same time. I also have some more progress on some pieces that I think I have more progress. I think I've painted things. I think I have more progress on some other things that I showed you that I had started too. So if I remember to, I will also show you those in this video. Please do not judge me if I forget to show you those by the end. I'll try. It's been a week. Anyway, behind me is the two-piece 8x8 canvas series that I started last time. And that's the first one we're gonna look at. So, let's check it out. This one has been really fun to work on. I just have the base layers down. So this is, I've covered the background in, Prussian blue, prism violet, dioxazine purple, quinacridone magenta, a little bit of white, and a little bit of light blue permanent. These are all Liquitex acrylic gouache colors. And then on top of that, I did the clouds out of varying combinations of those same colors, trying to make sections of light where there will be lightning. And that'll be the next step that I do to this before I continue with the clouds. But the plan is to go in and add small cloud-to-cloud lightning strikes in here, and then let that fully dry and take these same colors in similar or differing combinations and make bigger clouds that will be closer to the foreground. And then from that I can have some larger lightning strikes. And then this bottom section here will be water. I started on that and then got overwhelmed and I stopped. So this is basically just 2.5 inches of blue, but it will eventually be water. It also makes sense for me to finish the clouds and finish the lightning before I get to the water, because then I'll be able to create reflections in the ripples that'll match where the lightning is above. But I'm really loving how this one is turning out so far. If I separate these two, you get kind of a better idea of what it'll look like in the end, because obviously they're not going to hang touching, they'll hang a little bit separated. So it is challenging to paint things like this, because I have to think about, I want this line to kind of line up but not line up too closely, so that when you separate these it still looks like a unified piece. It'll be more evident that it's a unified piece when I'm done, because I will put like a big lightning bolt through most of it, and that'll help a lot with really unifying this whole thing. This one I did this one like 2 nights ago, so it hasn't been done for very long, but finishing this one was really what inspired this video, because that meant that now I had something I could show you. But yeah, this has been a lot of fun. Like I said, trying some new techniques. I got new brushes. I have some nice like goat hair mop brushes. I got these brushes that you could say they're not the best, but like they're kind of the best, because that's the brand. I don't know if you can read it, but the brand is literally best. I had just kind of cheapy brushes from Hobby Lobby, and I had been wanting to invest in some nicer brushes, and then Jerry's Artorama had a sale, so best brushes were 50% off, so what was normally $8 a brush was like $4 a brush, and so I got a lot and didn't spend a ton on them, so yay! But that really helped push me forward on this piece, because I really, really, really needed a mop brush to be able to do the clouds with this kind of texture. It is so easy with a mop brush. I had been using this guy, who is a half inch square. And you just don't get the same texture. And for this one in particular, I really wanted these nice fluffy clouds with just that little hint of very watercolory white for the lightning. And I think that it turned out super well. Let me know what you guys think, because I am loving how this one looks right now. But let me show you the next one. This is the next one, and really what you can see here is everything that I've done anything to. So this is that long skinny one, and this is what I have done so far. It is nowhere near done, but this is a good start. This is in what I am currently colloquially calling my Space Girls series, where I have the silhouette of a pinkish, purplish, yellowish lady who is interacting with a star or moon, depending on your perception of this. I'm not going to tell you what you should see, because if I'm being totally honest, I haven't really decided. I just know that it looks very celestial and I love it. This has, this whole series was an idea that I have honestly had since I was a kid. I've had this idea, this like vision in my head of these figures like blowing the like white flecks and creating like a big moon or a star, or, and maybe it's just they're creating celestial bodies in general. But I am absolutely in love with this series. This is the third one, which I think I told you in my last video. And I really love how this is turning out. I think this is honestly the best face I've ever painted. I don't really do portraits. I do a lot of figures, but I do them like intertwined into like a tree. So trying to do a realistic face isn't something I ever really do, which made this really, really difficult. I found the perfect reference photo, and that is what I attribute my success to on this one. But in future, she will have some very swirly aqua and kind of greeny-bluey hair that'll go all over the place, up and down. And then these are supposed to be representative of her hands, and I will have more of like a dark purple coming out farther on the sides that should make that a little bit more obvious here. Loving this one. I don't know when I'm gonna finish it. Unlike the last one and the next one that I'll show you, this one is entirely acrylic, because this whole series is entirely acrylic and I didn't want to change in the middle. So, an acrylic series, which I haven't done that much in acrylic lately, so this one has just been a kind of a nice change of pace and really fun to work on. I'm actually going to show you another acrylic piece before I show you the last gouache one that I've been working on, because you remember this one that I started ages ago? So I think I've shown you this one before as a work in progress. I'm still not done. This one is also entirely acrylic, and this one I have to blame for why I've had to wear a wrist brace now when I paint. It's you, friend. It's you. So it turns out that doing this motion repeatedly will really strain your wrist. And with how many tiny details there are on these trees, as you can see, I'm still not done. It has been grueling for my hands. But one day she'll be done, and then she'll be able to go on her merry way. But I am loving this one. I am super pleased with how it's turned out. It's just been an absolute pain to get there. But, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And I do love it. I'm not sad that it's taking No, it's not that, because I am sad that it's not done yet. I'm not sad that I did it. I'm not sad that I decided to try this bark technique, because honestly, I love it. I love the texture of it. I think it looks really, really cool. I'm just sad that I've had to take it so slow on this one so that I don't injure my wrist more than I already have. That kind of sucks. But, c'est la vie. Last but not least, we have this one, which I think I was the most excited to work on. And again, I kind of wish that I had waited until my new brushes got here, because I really think that this little mop brush would have done wonders on these clouds. And honestly, I'm considering going in and adding some more cloud layers anyway. I'm not amazingly fond of the clouds at the top, but at the same time, I like how it looks right now. So, I don't know, we'll see. I might add just like a couple of closer clouds that could potentially block some stuff that would be in the foreground, but I don't know. We'll see. It might just turn into me adding just like a touch more white to these guys. We will see. But I do love how this one is looking so far. I love the color palette, and I am really excited to see what happens with this one in the future. I haven't finished mapping this one. I don't know what I'm doing where, which is really funny because this was the first one I started working on after the last video that I showed of like doing the color mapping on these. This is the first one that I started working on, and it is now the one that I'm looking at and going, I don't know what I'm gonna do with it. It's probably about a third of the way done, and we will see when I end up finishing it. I also, when it's this big of a canvas, I do like to take my time on it, so I'm trying not to rush on the idea of doing this one and getting it to be exactly where I like it and fully deciding what I want here. I will probably work on like grasses and rocks and stuff for this whole section, and then maybe a couple of trees, or I might just leave it as grasses and rocks and potentially add a fox, because I always add a fox to my forest scenes, let's be fair. So more than likely a fox, but I don't know where. I haven't compositionally figured out how I'm going to do that yet, but I do love how the mountains turned out. I like, they all have one color in common. This green is in all three of them, just in different dilutions, which I think looks super cool, and I'm really, really pleased with that decision. So now I just get to decide what I'm doing with the rest of it. But yeah, that is what it looks like in my office, because I'm working on four different things at the same time. I still have four other canvases on the floor behind me, but those are all pieces that I have no idea when I will be starting at all, so I'm not really counting those as official works in progress. But yeah, these have a significant amount of paint, and most of them have ideas. Ignore this one, ideas will come in time. And that is what it looks like for an artist who is indecisive and can't work on only one thing. I need to work on several. I just can't help it. Thank you guys for understanding. And I'll see you next time. Bye.